Hey guys, it's HoppingHammy, and I have a special guest with me today. Well, two special guests actually, if you count Mushroom, the hamster that I'm holding right now. Mushroom is Taxonomist's hamster, and Taxonomist is my friend from Hamster Hideout that you most likely will remember from past vlogs we've filmed together. So today Taxonomist is going to be showing us everything that she has in her first aid kit. This kit is great to have on hand for hamsters, and I think you will find this video quite useful, so I'm going to go ahead and let Taxonomist take over from here.
Hey everyone, this is Tax. We're going to start going through my first aid kit. We're going to start out with some stuff that I don't necessarily keep in the kit. It's kept in the fridge or elsewhere. The first thing I have is baby food. This is not all that I have. I have an entire drawer of it. This is just really good for a hamster that's not eating to try to coax them to get some nutrition into them. I have all different types. This one is a apple, strawberry, and beet, so it's primarily fruit-based, but I also have things like veggies with spinach and lentils, and then just sweet potatoes. The other thing I have here is some pediatric electrolyte solution. I have two different brands here, just a generic unflavored brand and then Enfolite. I really do like the Enfolite because it doesn't have any artificial flavors or colors or sweeteners, but it still does have a fruit flavor. I've tasted this stuff. It tastes awful. It's absolutely terrible, and that could make it hard for hamsters to actually drink it. But the Enfolite has all of the flavors of other brands, but without the coloring. The one thing you do want to be careful about if you buy these is read the ingredients. I've seen some that contain artificial sweeteners like sucralose or aspartame, and these can actually be toxic to small animals. So just make sure you read the ingredients and make sure it's real sugar instead of any kind of sweeteners. So now we're going to get into kind of the meat of the first aid kit. The first thing I have here is washcloths. You'll see I have lots of them. These are just from IKEA. They're like $3 for a 10 pack. But these are one of the most heavily used things that we have in the first aid kit. They are really the only way to get medicine into a hamster. And I actually have my little stress hamster. I can demonstrate how we do it. But we just kind of wrap the hamster in the washcloth to cover their arms. It's almost like a little hamster straitjacket. And that way we can hold them and administer the medicine in their mouths without them using their paws to push the syringe away or anything like that. And it minimizes us getting bitten. It minimizes stress for them, because you can also kind of cover their eyes, which does calm pretty much any animal down if you're trying to restrain them, just covering their eyes so they don't have to see and be overstimulated. I'm gonna kind of start from the back here. I've got some other little pouches. There's stuff hidden all over this kit. In here, I've got some hardware type stuff. I've got a little pack of Q-tips, just for cleaning off wounds or brushing around the eyes or sensitive areas. I also have some black tea bags with some written instructions. Black tea can be used to slow bleeding, and I have the exact preparation detailed here so that I don't have to look it up in an emergency. And I've probably got about 20 bags in there, so I've got plenty to do whatever is needed. I've got some little alcohol swabs. These are kind of the ones the doctor would use on you before you get a vaccination. These are just for sanitizing my tweezers, my clippers. They're not for use on the actual hamster at all, but just for cleaning off equipment. And then I have the equipment kind of just bouncing around in here. We've got a couple types of tweezers, slant tip and a fine point tip, which are covered because they are sharp. They're good for removing any kind of splinters the hamster has, even just see an area a little better by pushing aside the fur. I've got little itty bitty nail clippers, which we're probably not going to use as much anymore because we actually have a better solution that I'll show you in a minute. But these can be used for clipping claws, obviously. But what we kind of prefer to use is these. These are suture scissors. They're meant for cutting out like stitches if someone has stitches and needs them removed. But the nice thing is they have this tiny little hook here, and that can be used to hook onto the hamster's claw to make it easier for you to clip it. And then I have, which has leaked everywhere, so don't mind all the white powder, this is cornstarch. This can be used if we do hit the quick to stop bleeding. The nice thing about cornstarch is that it is non-toxic. The first thing the hamster is going to do is try to chew on or lick the wound. So you just dip the claw in here and it kind of clots it up and stops the bleeding. The next thing I have is some eye wash. This is just basically purified water with some gentle preservatives in it. It's good for cleaning out the eyes in case of irritation. I don't know if anyone's ever tried to wash their eyes out with tap water. It hurts and it's not comfortable. I've actually used this stuff myself, and it really is nice and soothing. It is very safe. It's mostly water. 99.05% just purified water. It has a little dropper tip, and so it's good. You could just put it in the hamster's eye to kind of soothe it, or to try to wash out dust or any kind of irritation they might be having. We have some hardware here. I have syringes of various different types. These are just the plungers, no needles. I've got 1 milliliter, 3 milliliter, and 10 milliliter. They can be used for a bunch of different things. They could be used for putting some saline solution in to wash out a wound. They can be used for administering like a soft diet or water or hydration solution. Not something you're going to use a ton, but they're good to have on hand because it's not exactly something you can DIY at the last minute. Next, we have some little pipette things. These are just basically like eyedroppers. They look a little different, but they come in a multi-pack, so they're single use. Same thing as the syringes. They can be used to wash out wounds, all of that. It just depends on what tool you need for the job. The last thing in this little pouch is these little cotton-tipped applicators. They're basically like Q-tips, cotton swabs, but these are sterile. And I'll actually open them to show you kind of what they look like. If you've ever been to the doctor, you've probably seen them before. They come two to a pack, and they're just kind of like a long-stemmed cotton swab. What's nice about these is that they're not real fuzzy like the store-bought ones are. So they're not going to leave fibers in wounds or near the eye or anything. They're just kind of firm. They are spongy and absorbent, though. These would just be nice if they're with a wound, rather than using the Q-tips, which aren't sterile. And you don't want to introduce any additional bacteria or anything. So we've moved on to the other side of the kit now. This is where a lot of the real meat and potatoes of the kit is. First, I've got some non-stick absorbent pads. These are just in case of bleeding to absorb the blood. They do have little adhesive tabs that aren't really useful for hamsters because you're obviously not going to tape it on the hamster, but they were cheap, so it's like, it'll do the job. I've also got some gauze for kind of a similar purpose, for even wrapping wounds if needed. Things would have to be pretty bad to have to do that, but you never know. And then I have these little tiny twist top containers. These just contain a pre-measured mixture of sugar and salt. Each one of these gets added to a cup of warm water to make a rehydration solution. It's kind of an alternative to the Enfalite or the Pedialyte. I like to have options on hand in case one thing isn't working. It's like, okay, let's try plan B. I've got this. The nice thing about these, I found them at Target, I think, it makes for a little single surf pot, so if something is happening, I don't have to stress out about, okay, what's the ratios for this? How do I do this? They are pre-measured and just ready to dump in some water. I've also got some nitrile gloves. These are just for handling, you know, if you've got open wounds to avoid infecting them with any kind of bacteria. They're really thick. They're not going to do much if the hamster tries to bite you, but they're just a good thing to have on hand to prevent any contamination. Next thing I have is some quick stop. This is similar to the cornstarch that I had before. Same purpose for stopping nail clipping bleeds. I don't necessarily like to use this as much because it's not the greatest thing for them to eat if they do try to chew it, but I do keep it on hand just in case of something really bad and the cornstarch isn't doing it. Like I said, I like to have alternatives lined up. I've also got some aloe vera gel. I ordered this off Amazon. This can be used for skin irritations and things like that. I want to note that this is different from the sunburn relief aloe gels that you find in drugstores near the sunscreen. Those contain a lot of thickening agents and preservatives. This is literally 99.75% aloe with a couple food grade preservatives. It's very, very different. It's a lot more watery, but it is safer for them to eat and does contain a lot more aloe than those other gels would. Next thing I've got in here is some Benibac gel. These are little tubes of gel that contains probiotics. This isn't so much an emergency thing, but this is really beneficial to give to a hamster that's on antibiotics. They're prone to something called antibiotic enteritis, which basically means that antibiotics upset their stomachs. The probiotics can help to prevent that from happening and make them a little more comfortable. So I like to keep a couple tubes of this on hand. The next thing I have are some little tubes of saline solution. It might be hard to see what they are, but basically they're just little individual tubes. You twist this to snap it open, and you apply the solution. This can be used as eye drops, for cleaning out wounds, and the nice thing about these is that they're single use. Saline solution, you always want to make sure it's sterile because you can get bacterial growth in it. I've also got some saline wound wash, sort of similar to the little packets. It is in a pressurized can, so that keeps it sterile after it's open. This comes out with a little more force, which I'm not sure it's always going to be a good thing, but again, just another alternative to have on hand. In here, I have some critical care. I have both the regular apple banana flavor and then a fine grind, which I'm not sure if that's apple banana or the aniseed flavor. It's one of the two. But critical care is a supplement designed for small animals to help them recover from surgery or illness. It's not a medicine, it's just food. It's powdered and you add water to it to make sort of a thick paste. It's really kind of hard to deal with because it sticks everywhere. But it has all of the vitamins and minerals and protein and fiber that they need to help them recover. I will often mix this with some baby food to make it taste a little better. This has been a literal lifesaver for many of my hamsters to keep them alive and well and going until we can get them to the vet or until their medicine kicks in. And you can buy it online. I would definitely recommend having this on hand for anyone who has hamsters. The next thing I have in here is some Manuka honey. This is the K-Factor 16. Manuka honey has some limited antibacterial properties. It can be used on wounds or on irritated skin. It is safe for them to lick off. It's honey. I have also been known to add this into the critical care mix to make it taste better. This is a little pricey. I think this jar was $30. If you can't afford something like this, I would skip it. It's not super, super essential like I would feel critical care or syringes are, but it's nice to have on hand if it's something you'd like to have. Thanks so much, everyone, for taking a tour through my first aid kit with me. I do want to make a final note before the video ends. None of the stuff in this kit is meant to replace vet care. It's meant to keep a hamster alive, stable, and comfortable until we can get them to the vet. For example, one night we found our hamster Milkweed weak and wobbly. She was barely able to move. We gave her some critical care and baby food mixture to get some energy into her. However, we also took her to the vet a couple hours after we found her. She was there diagnosed with congestive heart failure. Obviously, critical care would not have fixed her heart failure. She needed vet-prescribed heart medications for that. On the same note, something like the Enfolite or the hydration solution isn't going to cure diarrhea. What they will do is help the hamster to stay hydrated and increase their chances of staying alive until we can get them to the vet. Having a first aid kit is really important and really useful, but it's not a substitute for vet care. Rather, it should be used alongside vet care to keep the hamster in good condition between or before vet treatment.